So returning back to the dormance of the self. Oh my gosh. I have what do we call it? There's a I don't know. I went into one of those little dressy stores and I said, okay, all right, if you need help, and maybe I'll help out. And then after, you know, I'd been there for a while, it appeared to me that there's an entire wall in that store, and every brassiere there was a size of 34 or higher, but like a cup D. And I'm like, oh my gosh. After a while, I'm like, no, I can't go there. I can't go there, and I can't be a salesperson. It's just not possible. So yeah, I'm like, well, what did I say that for? You know, what did I say that for? What did I jump to that for? That reason. You know, I'm gonna do what? I'm gonna sell a size cup D? I mean, if anything, that is a masochistic situation for me to go to. You know what I mean? Anybody below a D, that would be a state of masochism. So yeah, so tough store. And so I told him, I wrote him on the email that I said, no, I can't. I'm sorry. I have to decline. I have to decline because it's just, you know, wrong. I don't match you. I don't match that agreement. And yeah, but why is the realization taking so long? You know, why did it take me so long? You know, why didn't I just see them right away and go, oh no, that was a bad idea. They're all massive, you know. A very bad idea. Yeah, let's talk about adornments. They may be padded, I don't care, but they're still, you know, size D or more, you know, it was just massive. There's no way I could even sell them. You know what I'm saying? And they're the wrong people, in a way. They're all mothers, most likely. They've all given birth many times, and I am like, well, yeah, I don't fit in. I don't fit in then. This is terrible. The size massive. Well, and I'm like, well, I guess so. It's just the wrong place. So what's the deal now? Back to yeah. Why did I even adorn myself with that moment? You know, that moment of even the try. Couldn't I have seen it before, you know? And so now I'm adorning myself with that negative energy of my own abusive moment, you know? Gosh dang it, why didn't I just see it before? Why was it taking me so long to witness it? Or to come to that conclusion? You know, why would I even have to bother the woman? Why would I even have to ask? Why did it take me so long to come to that conclusion that obviously I'm not going to be happy there. It's just an abusive, a masochistic situation. Yeah, I mean, and talk about it, you know, is there on another wavelength? Many of them are just on a completely different wavelength that I can't even get near. It's perhaps something to just do with the body type, you know, with that much extra. I just don't feel I belong. I don't feel like I belong in that fathom of female group. So, yeah, I had to turn that job away. So. Yeah, and unfortunate, most of like the young, girly, sweetie shops, you know, they only want the 16-year-olds there to sell it, you know, 16 to 25 or something. And so that's not good for me. So I think I'm going away from clothing quite quickly because I Yeah, I don't fit the woman, the typical American woman look. And I can't say it's typical American woman only because in France also, in the major cities, they were on supply, on sale with this massive size again. So I don't fit in with the massive sizes, of the brassieres. And so because of this, I can't work in a woman's clothes store. It's just unbelievable. So I'm starting to see limits, like I mean, just limits that, yeah, I have no comprehension of them and their situation. You know, no comprehension of yeah, we have nothing in common. You know what I mean? Nothing in common. And so as a saleswoman, I would be terrible. Also, and the shoe store that I applied for, their major feature was narrow shoes, narrow. That they could sell and supply narrow shoes. And I don't wear the narrow shoes ever. And so that was an extra added on. So I've been going up to these strange situations where the shoes are too narrow and the brassieres are too large. And I'm starting to realize that I don't fit in with the standard woman. I don't fit there. So I don't know. Like I said, it's not an adornment though, that's just a reality. That just is a reality. It's not really an adornment. I guess that's a deal. That's a deal with adornments, is we have to recognize that there are certain realities that are realities. That are nothing to do with you. It's just a physical reality. Absolutely a physical reality. Before any clothing, before anything else was added. Yeah, so I'm adding reality into adornments that. I know the women there, they put them on the extra, you know, they get the silicone or whatever now, vegetable oils. And they have those things associated with extra. And when they do all of that, gosh dang it, I'm really fat all day. And when they're doing all of that, they're adding the adornment. You know what I mean? They're adding the adornment. Just like this necklace here, extra. You can't take it off, though, as easy. And in a way, what is the deal? They want to fit in, they want to look that, they want to look like they've had the two or three children, you know. I guess so. I don't know. Is it for the men really, or is it for the women? You know, is that adornment extra, that silicone one, is that for the men or is it for the women? Yeah, so what is it I'm trying to say? Yeah, I can't work in the women's clothes store. Will be a terrible women's sales product person. Yeah, not good. So I was waiting for About.com. They're supposed to give me a job as a you know, at least a blogger. Come on, give me a blogger job. I'm waiting. Yeah. And then what is the other one? What is the other one? Yeah, and then I can adorn myself with words at least, you know. Words and words. Oh, it's a lot of work. I know. Oh, the bavi bavi. I know. I was heading down that way. We can make the bloggers and the artists and the vloggers union of the internet there. Yeah, let's go then and do that. No, they're not contacting me. What's the deal? Oh, is that it? Is that it? I don't wear the size of 42 or for D's. Maybe that's all it is, you know. I don't want to wear that adornment of think thought, you know, that that's what I think others are thinking about me, you know. Yeah. Now, because that can become like a wretched paranoia. You don't want that. You don't want to wear wretched paranoias. Gosh dang it. Well, anyway, gosh, this is like the depressant show lately. I'm sorry. If you're feeling too high and mighty, just I guess there you go. You have somebody to click on to. You're getting too like up. Maybe you're taking flyers or something, you know, something that just makes you just fly to the moon. You gotta like, shh, chill out, chill out, chill out. I'm not flying that high, everybody. Just chill. Not that great. If you need that, you know, I guess so. I guess I've been a good show for you today, you know, just ground you out. Just get you back into that mud, at least for a moment. Stop bouncing off the planet.